saya nang bawat damdamin. Ang tibok ng puso sa bibig, para bang tuyong na ng langit.
There is no precise record as to when this practice started in the Philippines. However, it is clear that the religious missionaries brought this practice from Spain through Mexico in the 16th century. A Jesuit priest by the name of
Ignacio Francisco Alsina
recorded that this was celebrated in some parts of the Philippines at the beginning of the 17th century. From 1680 to 1689, these practices were discontinued by order of the Archbishop of Manila,
Felipe Pardo.
There were abuses resulting from the improper behavior of the assembly and the choir for religious celebrations and places in the Diocese of Seville. There are no records of the exact year when the practice was resumed. What is accepted is that from then on, the dawn masses were celebrated without interruption until our times. It was at the first plenary council of the Philippines in 1953 that a formal petition to Rome was made. As a consequence, an indult was granted. The council stated that there is a legitimate tradition in these islands coming from ancient times to celebrate the masses, popularly called
Misa de Aguinaldo,
for the perseverance of Filipinos in the Christian faith and for the preservation of religion in this area of the world. For 9 days preceding the Nativity of Christ the Lord, the solemn votive mass, Rorate Caeli de Super, is sung with great solemnity and with massive attendance by the people, one mass every day in the churches. On March 24, 1961, Rome granted the continuation of this indult for 5 years. This is above all an expression of the Filipino filial devotion to Mary, the Mother of God. For 9 consecutive days, we join and accompany her, so to speak, as she awaits the birth of her son. For this reason, we celebrated these solemn votive masses in her honor. The declaration of martial law modified the time of the celebration in some places. The adjustment from dawn to evening was in view of the curfew hours imposed during the martial law regime. Today, this practice continues to be kept, even if the curfew hour restriction is no longer in force. Everywhere in the Philippines, the Simbang Gabi is celebrated with great solemnity, with the singing of the Gloria in white vestments and with Christmas carols and festive ornamentations, in contrast with the sober character of the Advent season. Many of our faithful who follow the urban rhythm of work find it easier to join in the evening instead of the dawn masses. This adjusted time allows them to continue receiving spiritual nourishment and appreciation of the Christian meaning of Christmas amidst its secularized celebration. It is popularly called Simbang Gabi-Sagabi. It should be motivated by genuine pastoral care for the spiritual benefit of the faithful.
Kampana ng simbahan ay nanggigising na, at waring nagsasabi na tayo'y magsimba. Magising at magbangon, tayo'y magsilakad, at masiglang tumuhin ang ating simbahan.
One of the customs related to this is the selling of traditional Philippine food, such as puto bumbang, a purple-colored rice pastry seasoned with grated coconut and brown sugar, chocolate, a hot chocolate drink, bibingka, flour and egg cakes cooked with charcoal on top and under, and salabat, or ginger tea, which are sold by vendors to the faithful outside the churches. When Simbang Gabi is celebrated in the evening of Saturday and Sunday, one should take the liturgy of the Sunday. It should be noted that Sunday evening Mass should not anticipate the weekday Mass of the following day. For the Mass formulary of the weekday Seem Banga B, the Common of the Blessed Virgin Mary in Advent, Rorati, Chaili, Day, Super, should be used with Gloria. Advent Preface Number 2. An white vestment. The supplement to the Roman Sacramentary gives us the Mass texts for the prayers and the readings. The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines has approved that the readings for the December 16th Seem Banga B are from the Friday of the third week of Advent, Isaiah 56, 1-3 and 6-8, and John 5, 33-36. The ordinary place for the celebration of the Seem Banga B is the parochial church. Chapels which are duly recognized within the jurisdiction of the parish church are given permission to celebrate Seem Banga B only with the consent of the parish priest and in coordination with the parish. Seem Banga B may not be celebrated in malls or shopping centers unless there is a chapel in the establishment where the Holy Eucharist is celebrated with frequency and duly approved by the diocese. The Misa de Gallo, on the other hand, refers to the midnight Mass celebrated on December 24th, while the Aguinaldo Mass is the votive Mass celebrated at dawn of the 9 days before Christmas. As we prepare for the celebration of the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ, through the unique Filipino Catholic tradition of Seem Banga B, may the faith and devotion of Mary, the Mother of God and the Mother of the Filipino nation, inspire us to receive in our hearts and home God's surpassing Aguinaldo in the person of Jesus Christ.
Ang Simbang Gabi kung Pasko ay sadyang dinarayo ng mga taga-bayan at maging